shit. Oh my god. Okay. This is difficult with a backpack on. I got this. Look out, Minneapolis. Ringo's on the loose with a fucking scooter. Haha. Suckers. Keep me away from a beer? Hell no. Yeah, it's really top heavy. Oh shit, lopsided with this backpack on. There's a fair amount of traffic out here, too. And they were very, very careful to inform me that I can get a ticket on this when I press the agree button. Oh, railroad tracks, here we go. Yep, yep, bunny hop. Some wicked bunny hop. Okay.
I've made it to the Holy Land. This is the only state I've been in other than Texas where they have Lone Star beer. Also notable, Grain Belt. Supposedly the best lager in America. But you can only get it around here. A little before 10 p.m. This is a street called Central Avenue, I think, Avenue. Zipped down here on the scoot, made it to the liquor store right before they closed. And I got myself a delicious Marzen style lager. And I can't even tell you how sweet the taste is after 2 days on that fucking train. Oh. Now I just need to find some sort of food that's actually open and affordable. Because I seem to have hit a hip little vein here. So, that's really the only other plan for tonight. And then I'm just going to find somewhere to pass out. It seems like I should just be able to sleep out on the street somewhere near here. But I might walk or take the scoot back to the waterfront area where I came from. Cheers, America. Out here on Central Avenue, northern Minneapolis, looking for a sleep spot in my normal way. I've keyed in on this church as being of possible use to me. I already passed over a couple, like, decent spots that I would take up if I were way more tired or way more desperate. But I am neither right now. Hello there. Nope. So, just kind of wandering. There's going to be something right around here, though. I can feel it. Bingo. Relatively secluded alleyway coming off of another alleyway. I feel pretty good about this spot right here. Ooh, holy shit, and there's a bunch of heat blowing out from whatever building this is. Oh my god, holy cow. It's so warm right here. And as additional security, just to kind of help keep me hidden back here throughout the night. It's really mostly so I feel better more than anything. Is anybody who sees me back here? Oh, God. Of the wheels. Anyway, I'm moving the dumpster. Come on. I'm going to position it in front of my body. hear is that anybody walking by says, "Hey, it's a dumpster in an alleyway," not, "Hey, it's a guy who may be dead in an alleyway." Morning time here in the alley behind the local auto zone. My spot was great. Nobody came by and harassed me or anything like that at all. I felt safe and comfortable. Slept in, it's almost 10. Turns out that friend of mine who lives out in Anoka actually lives like really close to the BN train yard where I got off. So I'm gonna try to meet up with her this morning, get a cup of coffee and say hi. And then otherwise, I'm gonna head downtown and just check out Minneapolis and St. Paul. The only thing I really want to do specifically other than the downtown areas is to go to the Pig's Eye Yard, St. Paul Yard, check that out. So yeah, film a little bit of that and then probably get back on the train tomorrow.
He lives up by where you live.
In Oregon?
Yeah.
Cool.
Anyways, and then another friend moved back here. Or moved here with his family from Tucson. I was like, what the hell is going on?
Someone that was with Southwest Conservation Corps?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. So interesting. Yeah, it's pretty cool.
You're going to be in one of my videos real quick. This is Holly.
Hello.
Holly, what was your official position when you worked for the Arizona Conservation Corps?
Hello. I was the recruitment coordinator.
So now we are, where are we, Holly?
We're in Minneapolis on the Mississippi.
Okay, we're on the northeast side, right?
Yeah.
Northeast side.
Northeast side, yep.
Mm-hmm. And it's the Mississippi River. And she just told me a cool fact. Down here, what happened?
That was the only natural waterfall in the Mississippi. And they dammed it when they started logging in Minnesota. And then they used the power to log the logs and the mill, like for grain mills.
The grain mills, yeah, which is a big thing out here.
Mm-hmm.
Nice skyline here as well. We're just walking. Minneapolis.
There's not really any snowpack. So sometimes we'll get like a 50-degree day in January.
So it just like constantly snows and melts and freezes. And
it can get down, like last winter it got down to like 50 below or something crazy like that. And you'd
absurd.
Walk out and you'd be like, your face would freeze.
Yeah, no, 50 below. No, thank you.
No, thank you.
But this is really nice right now.
Yeah.
It's right by downtown here, hanging out at the river. Found a cool spot by the tracks. About to head into downtown and check out the scenes. It's good to see my old friend Holly. Grand Belt Beer. It's a cool sign. I still have to find a track down some of that grain belt today. I've heard legends of the grain belt, but I've never had it. And here we have a grain train pulling through. Coming into the downtown Minneapolis area, I see a Starbucks where I will charge my phone. Here's the kind of cool cast metal sculpture, I guess, model of the waterfall Holly was talking about. It's kind of cool. Here's some artwork. We have big tall buildings. All that good stuff. So yeah, these are really cool. There's five of them along the way. I think we're in front of the Federal Reserve building or some sort of thing. A security guard just came to talk to me. Very nice guy. But totally recommend these. It's got cool cast metal sculptures of the city as it progresses. See here, it says the 20th century is when the riverfront area where we are changed from a commercial heart of the city to a railway center. This is moved away from the river. Anyway, and I guess that's what they're showing here. And then you got, you know, all the rail yards and bridge right there and everything. Anyway, super cool. The Great Northern Depot, yeah. I feel like I always end up at the Federal Reserve in big cities. I don't know how that is. And with that whole history and theme of water comes all the breweries and the beer. Being up here, kind of at like the upper end of the watershed for the Mississippi, they apparently have very clean water. I don't know, I've heard the river here is filthy and not a good place to swim, but I don't know. Beer, right? That's about how I'm feeling. Still haven't eaten anything today. It's almost 3 p.m. Probably walked a few miles. I need some pizza or something. Hennepin Avenue right here, or maybe it's Hennepin Street. No, that looks like Hennepin Ave, yeah, Hennepin Avenue here, and this is apparently kind of like one of the main drags, if not the main drag, down through here. The guy at Starbucks told me when you hit the strip club, you've gone too far. And I see a few strip clubs, but I've barely gone anywhere. So I think that might just be kind of how this street is. Anyway, lots of flashing lights and signs and nightlife looking stuff. Cool old buildings. It's got a good feel. Now we're walking down 5th Street Avenue. Can't remember again, but seems to be one of the other main drags around here. There's a couple other like streets right by where I am, but it's fairly compact, the downtown area, considering like how far the rest of it sprawls. So the most immediate concern for me is it's going to rain tonight again. And given that, I've decided to make today the Minneapolis day. And then tomorrow or possibly the following day will be the St. Paul day. We'll check them both out, but pretty much just looking to kill a day so I don't have to get in the kind of power outlet back there. So I don't have to ride in the rain again. So, anyway, going to check out some of the sites. There seem to be some cool parks, and like people keep telling me about a stone bridge up here. So I'm gonna go find that. I'm curious what this building right here is. It's what I imagine Hogwarts looks like. Apparently this building is the courthouse, which explains this. This is kind of a unique park. I don't entirely know how I feel about it. I sort of like it though. It reminds me of the dunes at the Oregon coast, where I sometimes go mushroom hunting. Got some like jack pine here or something. Railroad history everywhere here downtown. Part of those historical markers I was reading earlier was how the railroads became the thing, and then eventually all of the industry and the railroad as well moved away from the river, which is probably good for the water quality. So along with the quality and abundance of water here, the other thing that made this place historically relevant or important was apparently the quality of flour, or maybe more so the grain. And you can see right out there, Pillsbury, we all know that name. Pillsbury's best flour. They were one of the earlier ones, I believe, and then also we've got this gold medal flour building over here. And, you know, I don't know if those are in operation anymore, I would assume not. Given what I've read. Yeah, I guess with all that, with the water quality and the grain quality, of course, once again, is beer. Delicious beer. So, weather moving in, I feel the wind blowing, and the clouds are picking up a little bit. It was supposed to be, I mean, these are parks, like, over here. And I'm sure I could camp out somewhere there. We're kind of back in a part of the country with a lot of foliage and shrubberies. So it's easier to hide than some places with something covered. Something like that. It's a construction site, it appears, so if I get lucky, maybe they won't be there on Saturday morning tomorrow. I don't know. I'll have to look into that more later. On the east side of the river from downtown, many now, still walking around finding a spot to sleep. Just want to point out this cool thing they got going on that I would love to see a whole lot more to move. And they're utilizing the roof space here. And I don't know, assumably that's just for people like walk their dogs, play fetch with their dog, or something like that. I personally would like to see food being grown on rooftops, or in your lawn, instead of grass, perhaps. I don't know. Makes sense to me. Here's a mulberry tree, speaking of food. I also want people to gather foods available in their landscape, but it's a finely balanced one. Too much would be too bad. So anytime I film a plaque like that, you're supposed to pause if you want to read it. And anyway, I usually tell you what's going on. This is the oldest framed house still standing in Minneapolis. Pretty damn cool. Beckons of a completely different time in history. A time I think I would have preferred to be alive. When we still had connection to the systems that give us life. Which nowadays, even if you want to do, it's very difficult. And it's really a privileged thing if you get to live that way. And I think about it every time I'm in the city. So many people just born here, stuck here, will never have the opportunity to leave if they want to in many regards. Then again, you probably have more freedom as an individual human being than you ever would have in history. I just met a British businessman on that bridge back there. You know, suit and tie, the whole nine yards. Had a very good conversation with him, though. He was from the UK, traveled around Europe, did the whole backpacking thing as a young guy, which seems to be way more culturally accepted in Europe. I don't know why. I guess Europeans are just older and wiser about a lot of things, but he recognized me for what I am and what I'm doing immediately. And we talked, and that was one of the main points we shared. It's bizarre how people can feel so trapped in their modern lives, and very much many people are trapped. But at the same time, there are always opportunities to change your circumstance, and those are probably better than they ever were in a lot of ways. And really, that's why I make these videos. Really, I just want to inspire people and show you what other possibilities there are for life if you are willing to think outside the box, live outside the box, perhaps suffer a little bit. Look at me. And as I'm walking around out here the whole time, I'm looking for places I could possibly stealth camp and be dry. Well, I definitely just found one. You got that for a cover. I doubt it gets very wet under there, and it's up elevated above street level. So for the most part, if you're laying flat up there, nobody's gonna have any idea you're there. It would definitely be enough to get me through the night until morning, when I don't really care if somebody kicks me out. I hope the audio is coming through right now, because this is karaoke smash mouth. Wait till you get older, maybe your man made the difference. Oh, something getting thinner. You might as well swim. Why's it getting warm, so you might as well swim. World's on fire, how about yours? I swear I like it, and I'll never get bored. Hey now. Man, I could do better than this. Fuck. Okay, I can hope you hear that. That yelling is karaoke. Like, you're not even trying to sing. I don't know how you are allowed to do this in public. That is noise pollution. You should get a ticket for that. It's ridiculous. Like, you can sing, but fuck, do you need the microphone? I don't want to hear you. Man, the people of Minneapolis hooking it up. Gentleman just walked by carrying a old boot that I've seen sitting over there. And I just said, hey, thanks for picking up, man. You know, it's cool when really anybody goes out of their way to clean up and pick up some litter around, especially down at the tracks. And you know what he did? He turned around and he brought me two beers. Labatt Blue, Canadian Pilsner, foreign beer. I don't know. This shit's probably expensive. Cheers, Minneapolis. And thank you, guy, who lives, I think, like across the street somewhere here. If you ever see this video, appreciate ya. Drinking this Canadian Pilsner makes me feel like Ian Perry.
Shit. Oh, sure.
Hey, I'm walking downtown. I just met this guy on the street. He's super cool, like everybody I've met in Minneapolis today. I'm gonna go get a beer.
In town, like there's that Sioux Lions hog. Minnie has a really cool skyline.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
It's nuts. Bike.
Is St. Paul kind of cool too? Do people like hang out there? I heard it's really just quiet.
It's for grown-ups. I guess.
Ah, okay.
So it literally, on the weekends, it dies. It shuts down.
Really?
Downtown St. Paul shuts down. There's only like maybe three or four bars that are open.
Crazy.
They're all hopping because there's just that
nowhere
place.
Else to go. Yeah, yeah, right.
But downtown, like proper, is just dead. Fuck.
Interesting. Yeah. So Minnie's the party town.
Yeah.
For sure. Yeah.
Yep. Yep.
Yeah, no, that's really cool. I definitely appreciate how all the stuff is consolidated.
Yeah.
I had no idea it was as much of a sprawl as it is, really.
There is a sprawl.
I mean, like, surrounding area anyway.
Oh, yeah.
Time from Anoka down to here on the train is
like
a solid 40 minutes. My plan, well, it's gonna rain all day tomorrow, huh?
Yeah, that's good.
Well, that doesn't bother me. That's a good reason to go to a beer fest, really.
I'll probably have tents and shit.
At some point, I need to get down to St. Paul and check out the drink. We just came up with a brilliant idea. Do you
don't
want
tell
to...
them.
You shouldn't tell the viewers?
No.
Okay, fine.
Tell them.
$20,000 idea. Exactly. He picked me up on the street in fucking Minneapolis. Bobby on
Walmart.
Hey, roughly what streets are we at?
Central and Hennepin.
Central and Hennepin. Otter's Bar, Minneapolis, Northeast.
Otter's.
Highly recommended. The bartenders are wonderful. Otter's Slim. Karaoke every night.
You know they put this up because they were too...
365 days per year. What?
They put this up because they were too lazy to paint over the graffiti that's behind it.
Mm. Yeah, well, I mean, I don't blame them. Cost effective.
Look at how big it is.
Yeah.
And it's just a bunch of panels.
That's funny. That they can replace.
Yeah.
I've stumbled into a hip, cool little place. I'm not gonna stay here because I don't know. It's like out of my it's not out of my budget, but it's sort of just out of my class level. I don't want to be here. Out in the movie theater. You can come in here. You can watch a movie, and if you buy a movie ticket, then you come over here. You get 25% off food and drinks. And you can take your booze into the movie. And I think that's a fantastic idea.
Or cumbia or whatever. All you gotta do is find a girl that's alone and go up and say, hey, let's dance.
Surgery. It's not rocket surgery.
Thank you.
hanging out with these dudes I met Friday night in Minneapolis. It's a lively town. It's been a good night. Of the morning, almost 1 a.m. Got a BNSF Grand train coming over the river, heading eastbound. Maybe just up to North Town Yard, who fucking knows. Still hanging out with Dustin.
What'd you lose?
Oh, this is my water bottle, man. Just
crunching up against the railing here.
Oh, you have another water bottle?
Yeah, it's empty though.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Been hanging out. I got to do like a real Friday night here in Minneapolis. Thanks to
karaoke and everything.
Karaoke and fucking everything, man. Yeah. Thanks
and,
for
yeah. I'm and random dudes deep. On the street playing guitar.
Yeah, that was awesome.
You played guitar.
I played guitar a little bit.
Yeah.
That's right, nice. Folks. John Ringo plays guitar. Anyway, bedtime now.
Tomorrow, maybe hang out with this guy again and possibly go down to St. Paul, check out the pigsty yard and everything. Out. Underneath the bridge, keeping dry, the rain came in right on time, 2 a.m. I was actually still awake. Thanks, Dustin, for picking me up off the street and taking me out. It was fun. But yeah, we were like, it was 1:30 when I got back here. And yeah, I rolled my ankle pretty badly in the afternoon yesterday. And then walked another couple miles with the backpack, and then a few more miles last night without the backpack. And by the time I got back here, it was pretty bad, and it's pretty swollen today, and I can't really walk on it. I definitely can't walk on it carrying the backpack. So I'm kind of stuck here pretty much, effectively. I don't know, if I get brave, I might try to hide my backpack somewhere and limp into town for food later on today. I'll probably have to. But for the most part, I'm immobile today, and I'm not going to do much of anything. But assuming I do have a brace for my ankle in my backpack, I want to give it a day either way, but I can put that brace on it tomorrow. And then tomorrow the plan will be to go down to St. Paul like I had wanted to. It works out all right. It's a rain day anyway. Early evening, we're catching a glimpse of the sun. Storm is breaking. The people here are so cool. This guy over here, who unfortunately now seems to be getting harassed by the park police, just brought me McDonald's underneath the bridge. He was just down here fishing. It's back. We got round two. Freaking like, it's like rain in a mister. It's just rain blowing sideways. It's not big drops, but it's annoying. Beautiful morning. Sun is shining. Today is the St. Paul day. I'm going downtown to meet up with that guy Dustin, and we're going to take the light rail over there. this is the type of stuff that I like about the East Coast and the Northeast. I don't know why, just like this dingy brick alleyway with rusty metal hanging everywhere and this kind of bridges spanning the two buildings. It's just funky. We don't have anything like that out west. How new is that?
In the last like 2 years.
Oh geez.
Or 3 years maybe? Like, even though
All right, we're in downtown St. Paul now. Got the Mississippi running through and a paddle boat. Mississippi River, shit right there. Train tracks. I don't know. Okay, cool. Sold drugs, that would have gone perfectly.
I did in high school, actually.
So Charles Schultz is from St. Paul. Fun fact.
So you'll see these everywhere throughout the city.
Commemorative type things. Yeah, cool.
Something to him that like might be a derogatory thing, and
he
gets super pissed off.
Right. So what that really means is that you know you're into yourself enough that you have to deny being into yourself, so that when you do things because you're into yourself, you don't have to acknowledge it.
Exactly.
$3 minimum. Dining car satisfies. I have a full tummy and I'm ready to catch a train. I need water. We're gonna walk down to the spot now. Just a quick down street view of the Capitol building. I'm not gonna go down there because I have no business in the Capitol.
St. Paul,
as you may assume. But we are walking in the direction of the train tracks.
I'm not gonna do it. it. It's your only chance.
I'm here at the spot. I have good info that trains do stop here. However, so far this Chicago stack is moving pretty good. This seems to be stopping. Nighttime now. We've got a northbound VN stack passing through, and we've got a southbound CP stack. It's going kind of slow. It's picking up a little bit now though. I'm gonna try to get on it if I can. It should go to Chicago via Milwaukee. Well, so long, Dustin. It's been good hanging out, man. Just followed him into the bus stop and ate a hot dog. Going back to the yard. Down here at the spot, recommended to me by a friend, and you know, I've got to say, it really doesn't seem very good so far. Trains blowing through for the most part, nothing really stopping here, and I don't see a huge reason that anything would stop here other than maybe Amtrak around 10 p.m. I mean, I'm sure trains do stop here at some point, but it doesn't give me the feeling that it's very often or regular, even if daily. Another fucking BN junker train. I do not want to ride. I couldn't even get on it if I wanted to ride it. Still down here in St. Paul at that spot my friend recommended me. 18 hours here watching the trains come through now, and it's not looking good. The majority of them are coming through at, you know, full speed or road speed. There were a couple that were like borderline to catch on the fly, and then one train stopped for about 1 minute, and it was the lowest priority train that it could have been. So I don't know really what's going on. I know people who have gotten out of here without any trouble, but you know, they said it should happen within 6 hours. Down here in a nice neighborhood in the Midtown area, because we're midway in between St. Paul and Minneapolis, just pulled over at this lovely little park to do a quick beer review. Here we have the Tipsy Tomato. Look at him. He looks pretty tipsy. Tip, shake, and enjoy. 5.5% alcohol. Classic Bloody Mary cocktail made with malt beverages and alcohol already in it.
I think they put that on the can like three places. Anyway, you know me. Red beers and parks in the middle of the day for life. Let's see what we're getting into with this bad boy. Huh. Okay. It's kind of like a Bloody Mary, particularly right at first. You get a big punch of tomato juice right in the face, but then it becomes kind of like sour and very limey. And you get a little bit of like, you can kind of tell that it's malt liquor, quote unquote, somehow. I don't know, not bad. Would not buy over a Tecate Diablo, however. Not by a long shot. Okay. So yeah, I'm going over to Midway Yard. Just gonna check that place out. Yeah. Over here in the area of Midway Yard, well, really like right above it, there's a few different like parts of the yard, or possibly even an extra yard I did not know about. I'm not sure what this is. I guess it might be part of Midway. Same thing with this down here. There's a lot more than you can tell. I don't know. It looks pretty alright. It's open. It wouldn't be hard to catch a train here. But just looking at the lay of it, it's lined by all of this industry and fences, and I don't know, I could definitely see myself spending a day here chasing trains around, trying to nail down right where they're gonna stop or whatnot. I mean, I could probably just find a spot a mile out that way and everything would be fine. But given everything I've seen, I didn't think St. Paul was fantastic. I don't know if this is fantastic either, but what I do know is that where I got off at Northtown Yard seems better than either of these spots. I'm glad I went to St. Paul, I'm glad I came here and checked this spot out, but I'm just gonna go back to Northtown. I see no reason to make this more complicated than it needs to be. And that, good people, is a hump yard in action. I've described this before, but they back the, they pretty much just push a string of cars up the hump and then they cut them loose one at a time. And then there is a whole bowl of classification tracks down here. And then there's another guy working a switch, switching the cars down the right track as gravity carries them. It's a pretty efficient way to do that. Oh, we got a Fred down there, huh? I don't even know if I can. Thank you.
go. That's my train right there. Not even an hour waiting here compared to 18 hours waiting at the other spot. I don't know why anybody would go anywhere else other than here, frankly. Seems pointless to me.
We do have a vehicle cruising along the train on the bull run as it pulls in. Okay, here we go.
I think that was probably the rail cop. So we do have a dark-colored SUV cruising along the train on the bull run as it pulls into the yard. He just went by me. I think it was probably the bull. I'm gonna get on anyway, I think. Alright, I'm in the yard. I'm looking for a ride now. I don't have long.